Hi, I'm Warwick from Hodder and Steenbeck, and today I'm super happy to introduce you to Andy Wardle from Cult of Paint. Now, many of you already know him. He's won more prizes for his work than I could list in an hour-long video, so I'm not even going to try. But we're really lucky that he's a great friend of Hodder and Steenbeck, and he's here with us today to bring you into the topic of pre-highlighting and how you can use it to get the most out of that beautiful model that you've just bought and can't wait to get into paint.
Hey everyone, my name's Andy, and in this video, I want to show you how to pre-highlight your miniatures. So a pre-highlight is something we can do to help out the paint we're going to put on after. So I've primed the miniature in black. I've actually used the ColorForge black spray paint, which is fantastic. So I really recommend any of those ColorForge sprays. And what I'm going to do is spray some white paint over the top of that, where I think the highlights are going to be. Now, this is particularly useful if you're doing a color that needs some help. Something like red, if you spray it straight over black, it can look a little bit dull. So by spraying some white where we think the highlights are going to be, when we do the red over that, it's going to help it be nice and powerful, a punchy bright red in the highlights. And then the parts that stay black, they're going to be a little bit darker. So it can also save time when you get used to the effect. For the white, I'm going to be using this Tamiya flat white. And I really recommend this paint because it airbrushes really, really well. It does perform a lot better than most whites, so I do recommend it. And they're also fairly cheap to buy. If we're using Tamiya paints, the only slight disadvantage is we do have to match it up with the Tamiya thinner. But it's a small sacrifice because it works so well for pre-highlighting. So really recommend picking up these two if you think you're going to end up airbrushing a lot. I've thinned the Tamiya paint 3 parts thinner and 1 part of the paint, and it just doesn't have to be too precise, but try and start off too thin, and then if you need to thicken up the paint, then that's not a problem. I always do a little test on something just to make sure the paint is flowing nicely. Okay, so we've got the miniature prime black. I'm happy with the dilution of my paint. I always like to test to make sure on something not as important, so maybe on the back of the legs here. So what I'm going to do is hold, you know, an inch or so away from the miniature, push down on the air pressure on the trigger and slowly pull back to release the paint, just to check how it's flowing. And you can see the Tamiya paint gives us loads of control. So we'll come to the front now. Now I'm confident the paint is looking good. What we're trying to do is just pick out, you know, the top areas to make them brighter than the bottom, and then it will look really cool and effective on the tabletop. So I'm going to hold the miniature at an angle like this, top down, angle the brush above it, and just try and pick out the different areas. So I'll carefully start spraying where I think the highlights are going to be, on the tops of all the armor panels. And I can build this up fairly carefully. You can be quite cautious as you build up your confidence, but when you get used to this, you can really do this pretty quickly. I'm doing this pretty carefully because I'm trying not to mess it up on camera, but you guys can work a little bit faster. So I've thinned the paint quite a lot, so you can see the white isn't coming out too powerful, but we are starting to get a nice subtle highlight. I'm not going to bother putting this highlight on the gun. I'll probably end up painting that with metallic paints. But for all the armor, like the legs, I make sure I get some highlights on there. Just going to work my way around the model, and you might need to do 1 or 2 passes on each section just to make sure you build up a nice bright white. So this is the first layer of white dried, so I'm going to add a second layer now just to bring up the power of that white. I've added a little more white to the cup actually because it was a little bit too diluted, but like I said, I think it's always best to start too diluted than too thick, so you get, you know, some splattering or some paint where you don't want. So a little bit thicker. Let's just build up these highlights. Get those nice and bright, especially on the shoulder pads, the helmet, all those areas we really want to draw focus. Here on the leg is a really fun spot to do the highlights with. So make sure you do nice highlights that run up the shin and a circular shape highlight on top of the knee. Don't worry about making mistakes because this is just to help your paint that goes on after. So it's not the be all end all. This is just to, you know, help what we're gonna do next. So if you make a mistake, just leave it and you can correct it with the color. But as you get more efficient at this, you'll make fewer mistakes. Build up that power on the helmet. You can see the Tamiya paint gives you loads of control. Just make sure it's fully dry before you build up and add another layer, but I love working with this paint. I don't use Tamiya paints often, but I always use the white for this pre-highlight process. So that's my pre-highlight finished, and you can see it already looks really dramatic. And you can imagine adding some color over the top of that is gonna give you such a head start. I really think this is a great effect for tabletop miniatures, because from that 2-3 foot rule, you can just have them looking really punchy, really dramatic. I just think it looks really cool on the tabletop. I really encourage you to try this technique if you're new to airbrushing. It's one of the key things and one of the most helpful things to learn when introducing the airbrush to our miniature painting hobby. If you enjoyed this video and you want to find out what to do after your pre-highlight, keep watching. There'll be some more videos uploaded with me, and there'll be plenty of more useful tips like this to come.